Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and basketball fans of all ages. Welcome to the Boys I Asses Basketball Final, featuring your Jakarta Intercultural School Dragons and your Singapore American School Eagles. We're going to introduce the teams before the tip-off, starting with the Dragons wearing the dark away uniforms. A freshman from Australia wearing uniform number 12, Scott Wijaya. A freshman from the USA wearing uniform number 11, Raya Swigart. A freshman from the USA wearing number 16, Dominic Dixon. A junior from the Philippines wearing number 15, Rafael Nkayon. A junior from Australia wearing number 20, Mika Kelsey. A junior from Japan wearing number 9, Yuta Inada. A junior from the USA wearing number 13, Kier Darmaji. A senior and captain from Indonesia wearing number 21, Nathan Sutrisno. A senior and captain from the USA wearing number 24, Garrett Passion. And a senior from China wearing number 5, Zawar Nasir. And now the Eagles in the light-colored home uniforms. A sophomore from South Korea wearing number 2, Min Kang. A sophomore from the USA wearing number 3, James Sudendike. A junior from the USA wearing number 10, Ryan Payne. A junior from the USA wearing number 6, Drew Suranjan. A junior from the USA wearing number 1, Austin Napierski. A junior from the USA wearing number 14, Jalen Coney. A junior, also from the USA, wearing number 12, J.J. Chu. A senior from the USA, wearing number 8, Anton Lorenzo. A senior from the USA, wearing number 13, Wyatt Germain. And a senior from the USA, wearing number 17, Armando DiCicco. The coaches for the Jakarta Intercultural School Dragons are Kurt Johnson and Matthew Beenan, and the coaches for the Singapore American School Eagles, Shane Fitz and Dan Skimmen.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here we are live at IS Manila. I'm Mr. Cotton.
And right next to Mr. Cotton is Mr. Buford.
We have Singapore American School Jakarta International School in the championship.
These were indeed the one first and second seeds heading into the tournament play, and they've held the form so far.
I think in pool play, it was Jakarta who edged out of Singapore 11 points.
Correct. Well, I don't know.
Jakarta started off day one a bit slow, a bit flat.
Been on fire, got the momentum going their way.
Should be a good game matchup wise. Jakarta with a good size, three big guys.
Who are our players to keep an eye on as we start the tip off here, Mr. Patton?
Thank you.
see what they got.
Hey, Jonathan.
Go, go.
One. Two. He's been definitely asserting himself throughout these couple days. So far, Mr. Cotton, 7-7. Looks like Singapore's running out of bounds play on B.
baseline here, coming off the foul. Number two. The little man finishes amongst the Giants. Offensive foul here on SAS. It's going to be just ball. Yeah, look like it. Well, you better than me. You know that. Up two, got about 3 minutes left in the first quarter. Nice combination inside-outside game, stroking some outside shots as well as some interior game also. So it's been an impressive effort so far. Well, let's unofficially say four. Yeah, still looking for him. Could be drawing up a set right now, coming right out of the timeout. So. It's a good call. It's a good call. Let's see if that holds the form. Number 14, step to the line for two free throws. That's the third team foul in just.
Jermaine Wyatt checking back in. Wyatt. Jermaine. First line of two, no good.
A little strong there. Catch that, Cotton? Did you catch the walk? Or? Okay. All right.
Oh, here it is. Dribble hand off to the cross screen. Pick and pop. Watch the pick and pop.
There it is. Late whistle. Both teams have three team fouls now. First foul on number two. See the three, be the three. A couple of those tonight. Does indeed. Just up two. We got just under a minute left in the first quarter here. Inside, outside. Pop back out.
You can hit it.
See the three. Be the three. Always a little dangerous to try and save it under the opposing team's basket or under your own basket. What do you think of that strategy there, Patton? As a former coach, what do you advise your players? It's logical. Shot off. Nope. Ran out of time there. Great effort by both teams there. Just got a 5-point lead after the first quarter. 2 minutes between quarters here, now that we're in the playoff format. 10-minute halftime. You guys will get out there. We'll get to enjoy 10 minutes of commentary from Cotton and I. It should be a sure treat to come. We've been thinking about how to fill those 10 minutes. Got something good in store. That's true. We wouldn't want to talk over dance. We definitely don't want to do commentary on that.
Back to basketball here, usually.
Let's stick to what we know best here. They've been on their game. Definitely, SAS seems to bring the best out of them.
2-3
Yep, hit some. Also hit a couple mid-range shots, some inside shots. It's been Yep, 21. So he does, but he's showing a different side of his game here. True. I think it's probably just a matter of time before they find their groove.
Yes, and they do.
Indeed. Anticipate a little rally here by Singapore, but let's see what happens.
Guys, match up right now.
Carter's ball. High ball screen. Cross court. Almost a travel. He turns it over anyway. Jalen comes up to it. JJ ups it to Payne. Don't give him light. Back to Jalen. Back to back. Step back. Oh, yeah.
He did. On the release, I heard the bang from here. Nice move. They stretched their lead up to 8 points here, so. We'll call that jump ball. Just person meaning just coach. Yes, I would actually concur with you also. It didn't quite look like a jump ball yet, but ref didn't have the best angle on it. He's doing his best.
Well executed.
Nice hang time there by JJ. Setting the ball screen there.
Nice pass.
Oh. Left-handed short hook there. In and out. Oh, in and out there. That shot looked good. It was halfway down, just rimmed out there. Singapore picking up their man-to-man at half court. Singapore coach wants them to extend that pressure. It's a freshman, not only a freshman, that's what we call a diaper dandy. Extended their lead to 10. And they seem to have stepped up their game now in the finals. I watched their semifinal game. What was that against? Was that ISB? Who did?
ISB.
Yeah. Trying my best. Watched a lot of girls' hoops over the last 3 days. But it's good to see the guys going out there also. Very well-deserved effort by TASS there. They reflection of their coach. They play from West Point. Disciplined, tough, well-balanced team. Cotton, what do you think? Are you expecting a rally by Singapore before we head into the halftime show?
Yeah.
So the first foul on number 20.
He's got a smooth stroke up there.
Gets nice rotation on that ball.
They definitely need to control those boards, and as a result of them not, you're going to get to see what the GIST coach dials up for their baseline play here. Nice change of direction there. Just didn't connect on the pass. Seems to be holding form now for the last couple minutes. Singapore definitely wants to keep this in single digits and probably more than that, make a run before the halftime ends comes to a close here.
A lot of credit to Jakarta on the defense. Guarding that high ball screen really well, that pick and pop, that door after the dribble handoff.
You know these offenses pretty well, huh? After three full on days. Could be. Yes, indeed. They've seen a lot of each other these past 3 days. A tall point guard always helps. Good take, though. Definitely a good take there. Yeah. Couldn't quite get comfortable there. Down to 7 with an opportunity to cut it to 6 here. Nothing but net. Cotton. I should have said Cotton. NBC. Wow, Cotton is fired up here, guys. It's now a 4-point game. Things are tightening up. Jess will maintain position there. They are struggling a bit. Singapore fired up coming out for this timeout. I think they were down, was it 26-16? Is this a six unanswered points, I believe. Right. This was the kind of the rally that we were talking about. I was anticipating. Yep. Right. Give them a taste of their own medicine. 4-point game. That's true. So let's see what Carter will do here, up four, whether they can maintain this cushion or extend it, or whether Singapore can possibly tie this game up or even go ahead. Nice looking play there. It's close, almost an and one there, but instead he'll go to the line to shoot two. Good looking free throw, a lot of arc there, a lot of rotation. Extends that lead to five. Were you calling me Cotton? I thought you were Cotton. Been talking a lot about him this tournament, and he's definitely stepping up to the plate here in the finals. Unfazed. Pressure is not getting to him at all. Really went on a roll there after their timeout. SAS had it down to four. It's been a 7-0 rally here coming out of that timeout. So great job by the GIST coach there, calming things down and taking the momentum back. 49 seconds left. Another one. We got, all right, 34 seconds left, so 10-second shot clock difference here. Would you do you like the quick shot here for two possessions or no? Good luck there, just didn't go. Let's see if you're saying push it, but they actually have the last shot here. Good-looking drive, though. Good-looking drive. And we go to halftime. Just. Oh, of course. Obviously. I mean, they're coming in as. Although they did beat Singapore in their first matchup without JJ, they're still. I'd say the consensus is they're coming in as the underdog here, and here they are at halftime holding a double-digit lead. So I would definitely be happy as a just fan. Cotton, are we getting a halftime show here, or are we gonna be filling 9 more minutes? They're in for a treat. Looking a little camera shy right here, trying to avoid this interview.
We got Darren Sturgeon to the left of us. I don't know if he's going to give us his thoughts.
Any comments on the first half there?
Well, over the past couple of days, of all the games we've watched, we haven't seen any team hit any mid-range or long-range shots, much like Just is doing today. They are shooting the lights out. Despite Singapore's tenacious defense. Interesting to see what's going to happen in the second half.
I know as a man of the older generation who grew up watching stars like Larry Bird, you've been very, very upset about the lack of mid-range outside shooting, and I'm sure you're happy to see it coming to fruition here in our final game. So that's great. Thanks for that input, Mr. Sturgeon.
You know, I mean, Jakarta, they've found opportunities in transition in the half court. 21 started him off with two deep twos. 24 has come alive with three threes for himself. And then you have the diaper dandy, unfazed, penetrating with the floater. A jumper for himself as well. You know what? If I'm Jakarta, I'm going with those five, the starting five. They are delivering.
Cotton, I feel like you have Cotton, you leaving me or what?
Got a stretch.
I feel like that freshman for Gist is somebody who's just been growing on you each and every day here. Now that we're in the finals, you can't contain yourself. Your enthusiasm is just so evident here.
He's a freshman and he is solid. No
solid indeed.
No
solid
turnovers.
Indeed. I'll tell you this though.
Composed, makes the extra pass, the right pass, and boy, he can shoot it a bit too.
Got a little Rihanna going on here now. For those of you at home, might want to listen to her instead of us. But we'll give you a few seconds respite from our commentary, so you can hear Rihanna.
We're back with assistant coach from Taipei American School girls team, the champions of IASIS 2017, Mike Corsini. Congratulations to you and your team. Heck of an effort. Give us your thoughts. How are you feeling?
Feels great. Girls are giggling. Must feel good to win a gold medal.
Oh, it must. I mean, Coach Kim, she's been with the team for how long?
Longer than I've been here.
4 years,
place, I believe, right?
Something like that, yeah.
She made a comment to me earlier since she arrived.
What do you think the key is for Taipei?
I think it's a year-round process. They go in and work out on their own, organize.
effort that they put in beyond
didn't start the tournament. It started.
Okay, great. Thank you, Mr. Corsini. Hell of a job.
What do you got right now? This one.
Back. No more Rihanna. I think they're ready for us.
No more Rihanna. That means it's Cotton and Buford time. All right. This team's just warming up here.
Oh. I don't know who this is, but we'll let them listen to this.
Yeah, that's it's a good call.
And we're back with a minute and 15 to go in halftime. Both teams are at their benches. The refs are here, looking beautiful as ever, ready to go for the second half. Buford?
We are indeed. And, you know, there's a school of thought amongst many coaches that the first 5 minutes of the second half are five of the most important minutes. Of a game
dinner
in basketball.
Down in the cafeteria is now open.
Let's see what happens
so if you'd
in the
like
next
to get
few
some
minutes.
Dinner.
Definitely.
Straight
Definitely
after this game,
SIS
or go down and grab a bite to eat, and then come back
there,
up
make a run
with
here.
The dinner
I would go
for the athletes.
The
first and the coaches is available in the cafeteria.
Come out, put the opposing team on their heels, really set the tone.
Well, Cotton, I'm glad you're putting your personal stamp on the game here because, you know, we all want to live and learn from the best. So check that for our audience. We're now going to the first 2 minutes.
I'm here for another 16 minutes of basketball here at 2017. IASIS, we have Singapore and Jakarta in the finals. Buford.
Doesn't get any better than this. Does not get any better than this.
Singapore ball. Jacob goes in the middle. Can he finish? He cannot.
Nice hang.
Agitated by that size there, Buford.
Nice hang time there. Just couldn't finish.
Singapore cuts it to 7 to start the half.
Are we back on here?
Well, they say we're back on. We just got a text message from a viewer. Apparently we weren't. I hope they can hear us.
Well, I hope our audience all around the globe was not deprived of our commentary for the first half.
Jakarta gets it, goes baseline. No, cannot connect. Good rebound by Singapore. Pushes up the right sideline. What will he do?
Strong drive.
Ah, can't finish. Good rebound. Oh, that's good rebound by Jakarta. Threw an elbow. Looked like he threw an elbow. Did the refs catch it? That could be an easy technical. Easy call for the refs. But did they call the technical? Is he calling the technical? I think that was clear. That was a clear.
I would say that happened right in front of our eyes here. That was undoubtedly deserving of a tech, but let's see what happens here.
That's right.
Looks like they may not be calling a tech. Let's see what happens here.
What's the call here? I don't know. Unsportsmanlike conduct, maybe?
Isn't that an NFL call, Mr. Cotton?
Well, here in the Philippines, that's what they use. Unsportsmanlike conduct.
Is that right?
Yeah. You saw it in the girls' game beforehand.
You're just a wealth of knowledge.
Well, here in the Philippines, they also have, as a warning, resentment towards the call. Go figure, Buford. Go figure. Oh, the first shot of the unsportsmanlike contact.
I think that contact. Was conduct.
Conduct, same. Oh, he misses them both.
That second one looked good. Halfway down, rimmed out.
Singapore will retain possession.
Cotton, you were harping on the first 2 minutes being critically important, and
another miss by JJ. Jakarta could not get the rebound. Singapore ties him up. I think JJ is really irritated by the size. Oh, the freshman gets free, pulls it out. Wise decision. We've been seeing a lot of those from him. Into the cutting. 24 cannot keep it. Whose ball? Buford? Oh, looks like Singapore's ball. turnover from Jakarta. We've seen very few turnovers from Jakarta. We just got an update from one of our viewers, Trevor Sturgeon in Singapore. He must be watching. He can hear us.
Trevor, I hope you can hear us.
Oh, we just inquired with him.
We actually just texted Trevor, so hopefully we'll be hearing from him sometime soon.
Oh, I hope he can hear us.
Me too. All right, two shots. 13. Singapore's gonna need to start hitting their free throws here.
Can't connect. That's the third miss of the half.
Third miss in a row. Let's see if they get this one. Down it goes.
They're back. Making one of two. We have Payne checking in. Can he get it going? He was on fire earlier.
So it's five unanswered points to start the half here for Singapore. So that's what they needed coming right out of half.
Singapore, or Jakarta, looking for their first bucket to the side. What are they going to do? To the high post. He likes to go left. Tripped up by number 13. What's that, his second? Jakarta ball.
Second personal on, number 13.
What are they going to do? Expect a cross screen, maybe a high ball screen. Who knows? To 20 it comes. Oh, he's going. He's going to the hole. He's determined. Can't finish. The freshman with the tip. Great rebound by Singapore. That JJ bringing it up. I think JJ is phased by the size.
There we go. Right there, number 10 finds his stroke. He missed a few in the first half, but that one certainly looked good.
He's one of four, but that doesn't matter to a shooter. They keep shooting.
That's now eight unanswered points here to start the half. Okay,
another
great
one. Oh, that's two in a row. He can shoot. He can shoot.
11 straight points. 11 straight points.
And a steal. Can he finish? Oh, and he finishes. He finishes. We have a timeout from Jakarta.
Wow. And this place has erupted as Singapore start out 13 unanswered points to start this half to take a two-point lead. And I believe we were saying at halftime, I don't know if our audience at home could hear the brilliance that was going on here, but we actually did say the first 5 minutes were going to be critical. And sure enough, Singapore has come out and asserted themselves right from the tip here. So let's see.
Well, they can really fill it up. Of course, you have a deep threat by JJ, who just hasn't been able to find his find his shot. But boy, 10 came in. Ryan Payne missed the first three in the second half, has connected on two in a row. What can you say?
Absolutely huge. Now, Just in the first half, responded very well after they called a timeout. They went on a run, so let's see if they can do the same thing here. 4.5 minutes left, third quarter. We got ourselves a great game here.
Yeah, we do. You know, I think Singapore was really in trouble. But, hey, two more quarters. We'll see.
You think Singapore's in trouble or
they
Georgia?
Were. They were.
Oh, they were.
Coming out of the half, they were really in trouble.
Okay.
Responded well. No, never count them out. They have the heart of the champion.
Indeed.
Nice cut by 13. 20 has it at the high post. He's looking to go one-on-one into the smaller 10. And he travels. Didn't look like a travel to me, Buford, but doesn't matter. See if Singapore can extend their lead. I think he's going baseline. Nope, he goes middle to the – oh!
He was failing it.
Offensive rebound. Oh, and I think that was a travel, actually. Drag that left foot. Pressure. 21 checking in. Twelve, number 12 brings it up under pressure. The freshman into 24.
They work inside.
I like this matchup. Oh, good defense by JJ. Don't give him light. Oh, a nice ball fake. Can't convert. Big rebound by the freshman.
Good looking move there. Just couldn't get it to fall down, but I like that move.
High ball screen, nothing. Pick and pop. 21's going to the hole. Finds his teammate underneath, and wow. He connects.
It's a nice pass in some heavy traffic there, but he found a way to get it through for 2 points, and we're all knotted up here. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter, 35 all.
Threaded the needle on that last one. Six, a little flex cut there. Top of the key. Elbow jumper, no. Rebound for Jakarta. Good pressure. Oh, with the diaper dandy. Can't connect. Here comes Singapore. Whoa! Picked his pocket, Buford.
Clean pick. Let's see if he can finish.
And finish!
Coast to coast.
Well, that's a big-time play. You know, Buford, players make plays, and
that's
he's
right.
A player.
He is indeed.
Flex cut there. 13 shoots it in an air ball.
And just has taken the lead back here. And again, their timeout seemed to settle them down, as it did in the first half. They've now gotten four straight here to go up by two.
Hello, can he finish? Yes, he can.
Six in a row. Same, interesting, really the same thing that happened the first half. The timeout and then the rally comes right after it.
That's a major size difference. If you like
really, really a credit to both of these coaches here.
That normal flex cut. JJ Pops can't get it to go. I don't know. Nice, scrappy offensive rebound. Throws it off his leg. Singapore will retain possession. Have substitutions for the two shooters for Singapore. Good defense, forced it in there. Jakarta with the steal. Cross court pass to the freshman. High ball screen, and he slipped it. What's he gonna do with it? He's gonna put it in the basket, Buford. That's what he's gonna do.
Wow, wow. What can you say? Eight in a row here, right? Eight in a row, they were down two, now they're back up six. Very excellent response here by Jis.
And another turnover by Singapore. Good defense by Jakarta. Driving kick, top of the key. Got a foul on the shot. That's a foul on the shot. That's three free throws coming up. Silly foul on Singapore.
Three foul shots.
We got Kong and Payne checking in. Singapore needs his shooting. Can he get it going again, Buford? Can he get it going again?
Well, we'll see about that. We'll see about that. Swan, where was the Cotton? Where was the
3-point line?
Where was the 3-point line back in your high school days?
High school came right up to the top of the key. This is FIBA rules, though. FIBA rules.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Really, really, really nice stroke there.
Connected on two or three. All three.
Wow.
All three free throws. That's huge. Garvis back up to a 9.
Just under a minute to go here.
Horn. They're calling Horn. What's it going to be? High ball screen. In and out dribble by Payne. Double clutch. Looked like some contact there. Hell of a finish.
Yeah, he's really looked like a different player in this second half. He's found his groove here.
Good switch at the high ball screen. And 17, stick with 24, I don't know. Here we go. Nice. Can he finish? He can.
Wow. 20 seconds left in the quarter. Let's see if Singapore holds for one shot.
Jakarta's answering.
They better get it over. Oh, there we go.
Calls. They weathered the storm. Let's see what Singapore can do. Oh, he gets a step. Step back. Jumper in and out. Another great rebound with 4 seconds to left. Oh, front iron. Buford, front iron.
Wow, what a quarter. What a quarter. Great, great run by SAS to start that quarter, and then a great run by GIST to close it. So started out with a 11-point lead for GIST and finished with a 9-point lead, but lots of back and forth there in that third quarter.
Well, you know, basketball is a game of momentum shifts, you know. Weather the storm, and for Jakarta, it was raining pretty heavy.
It was.
They made it through.
Impressive response.
For Singapore. Storm of their own, right, Buford? Huh?
Indeed. And I think the question now is, are we going to get another Singapore run here? I would not be at all surprised to see that happen here. Knowing Singapore, I just would not expect them to go down easily here. So I'm looking for a run pretty soon. Got the crew mopping the floor here.
They've done a hell of a job all weekend.
It's kind of reminding me of the old Boston Garden. The parquet. That was a classic.
A classic indeed.
The parquet floor.
Beautiful. My uncle got a piece of that floor.
Is that right?
Well, it's like we have Singapore ball to start the fourth quarter. Let's see if they can get it going. Payne and JJ are out. Who's going to step it up? I think Singapore's offense had to take some time to get balance there. Oh, hi. Jalen with the finish. I think that's his first.
That could be a good sign of things to come. Start out that
great execution.
11 seconds into that fourth quarter there. Let's see if he can complete the 3-point play.
Door cut.
Offensive board there.
Singapore, it's going to hurt you. Oh, and he finishes.
Here we go again. Cotton, 4 quick points. This is really a game of runs here. So down to 5.
If Jakarta can answer themselves. Oh, he has light. An air ball. A rare air ball. Offensive rebounds, Buford. Offensive rebounds.
Yep, you've been justifiably harping on that throughout the game. And once again, it comes back to bite Singapore.
Another turnover by Singapore. Jakarta has numbers. The freshman wants a timeout. And he got it. Nope. He didn't get it. Jakarta back up to a 9-point lead and a steal. Could he make it 11? The freshman. Timeout. Singapore won the timeout, didn't get it initially, and they got it this time, though. It's just hard to hear for the scorers table, unless the coach is right over in front of them.
I think we have a mistake there on the scoreboard, Cotton. Should be 52-41.
I think
52-41. All right, everything's...
They got it under control.
Everything's correct. I think we were kind of talking over each other there for a minute, so I'm gonna defer to you.
Buford, we were excited.
We were. There was a little chaos here with the scoreboard situation, but everything is now resolved. Back to the 11-point lead. Same gap we had at halftime. So run after run, but when it's all said and done, it's form is holding here.
Oh, that was a rhyme there. Run after run when it's all said and done.
Wow. Poet and don't even know it.
Well, let's see what Singapore comes out with the timeout with. Maybe they drew up a set. We have Payne and JJ back in the lineup. clearly their two best offensive threats. Oh, we have some confusion at the score tables again. I don't know about you, Buford, but I don't understand Tagalog. So we got to wait for an update in English from the ref.
In spite of the fact I've been here 5.5 years, I still have not made much of a dent in my Tagalog, which is an embarrassment to say, but I guess I'm admitting that to everybody out there. But
I'm not sure what the outcome of all that was, but they're back playing. JJ goes baseline, gets into his body, can't finish. Looked like he leaned into the defender.
I think Singapore is
at the line for two.
SAS definitely in attack mode at this point. Good shot there by JJ. 52-42. Stepping up to the line for a second shot.
Hey, if they can keep scoring with the clock stopped, that would be great for Singapore. They've cut it to 9. Oh, and a steal. Yes, Payne comes up with it. Kicked it to Drew. Drew, a cross-court pass deflected by 21. Singapore just called sideline. Expect JJ to run off a double screen to the weak side corner after he inbounds it. Let's see what happens. Oh, no, we got Payne. Oh, I don't think that's what coach wanted. We got the cross. JJ for three. No, hesitates. Gets to the hole. Can't finish. But he's going to the line.
They're like going to the line again. And as definitely clear that they are in full attack mode here. They're trying to get to the rim, cause contact, and they're going to want to hit their free throws down the stretch.
They definitely want to, and they are. Clock has stopped. They've just cut it to 8. Connected on both.
Great job there.
Big man coming back in for the freshman. And look at this lineup from Jakarta. They're going big. They're going big. Singapore's has the diamond one in place.
Diamond press here.
24 breaks it. Good deflection by JJ. Oh, nice. He's hit 2 already. Can't connect. Singapore with the rebound.
Good box out there by number 13.
JJ on transition, pushes, connects. Wow. He finishes, cut it to 5.5 left.
JJ is a man possessed now.
Oh, questionable call.
Wow. I don't know if the audience at home saw that. That was quite the theatrics there after the foul was called. Number 6 threw it from way beyond the three-point line and went right in. Unfortunately, underhand. That won't count, though.
Underhand. Anyway, timeout, Jakarta. 5-point lead. You see JJ really putting the pressure on the defense, getting to the hole at will, drawing contact or finishing.
Exactly. Their last few possessions, Singapore has just gone right to the hoop. And they're taking full advantage, so it's down to 5 here. They got the momentum. Question whether they can keep putting the pressure on or whether Gist is going to respond. Now, as I've made a point of before, after these timeouts that Gist has taken, they've gone on some runs. So let's see if that happens now or whether Singapore is going to be able to sustain this run that they're on.
Well, they've hit a lot of outside jumpers, but they've also connected down low. Of course, the offensive rebounds have really, really helped, which you haven't seen much of, Buford, in this second half.
True. So let's see if we do see that with 5:29 left in the game.
See the three-quarter court pressure here. A man to man. Deflected out of bounds by Singapore. The just coaches over here saying set screens. That would be great. Great idea. Oh, he's open for the lob. Doesn't throw it. Clear sign of size advantage for 24. Wrapped up. He comes through with it. Good rebound by Singapore. Hesitation gets to the hole. Can't finish.
Another drive.
I think almost that size is giving him fits.
Almost finished that, but didn't go down.
Oh, good movement. Good movement by Jakarta for three. They can't hit. Offensive rebound for Jakarta. Giving him another chance. He goes baseline. Nothing. And for three, Passion can't hit. Good rebound by Payne.
A little short on that jumper. Well, here we go again.
Oh! The little guy connecting with contact.
Is there any doubt here what Singapore's game plan is? SAS is just simply relentlessly attacking the hoop here in the fourth quarter. Once again, another run. This has just been one run after another.
Can he connect? You know, you have JJ off the floor. I think he might be cramping. He's been known to cramp. Needs to hydrate. Can't hit the free throw. Good rebound by Jakarta. What are they doing here? Gets a step. 13, oh, looked like a travel. Doesn't call it, can't connect. Oh, and another offensive rebound by Jakarta. That hurts.
Cotton, I'm just watching JJ on the sideline here. Our audience can't really see, but he's trying to roll out those cramps. Here he comes.
JJ subbing back in for Kong.
He seems to be fine.
Oh, my opinion, Buford, I don't know about you, he has no choice but to be fine. He's got to step it up. Cramps or no cramps, find a way to take his team to victory. He's the leader.
A la LBJ, LeBron James has also been known to suffer from cramps.
24 finds 21. Oh, and a nice block from behind. He sticks with it. Can't connect. Good rebound by Jalen. Payne bringing it up. Don't give him light. Little high ball screen. Oh, cross screen coming for Payne. He pops to the top. Wide open. 4-3. Can't hit. Good offensive rebound. He's fouled on the rebound.
Wow. And number 10 had a great look there, and he's been hot in this second half. Couldn't quite get that one to go down. But SAS going to the line, number 13, to shoot two with the chance to cut the lead to three here with just 3 minutes left in the game.
All quiet for Wyatt. He can't hit.
Let's see if the second one goes down here.
All quiet for Wyatt again. It falls.
Big one.
They needed that. Cut to four with 3 minutes to go. We got a timeout.
Four-point game, 3 minutes to go. Drama is in the building. Could cut the tension with a knife. Let's see how these teams respond coming out of this timeout. Got a lot of coaches in the stands who have done an excellent job throughout this tournament. Just saw the TAS
women's coach walking by, and her team
all
played
smiles.
Absolutely outstanding in this tournament. Congratulations to them for the gold, and also a valiant effort by the home team, ISM Bearcats. Just came up a little bit short, unfortunately, for the fourth year in a row, but they did, they gave it their all.
Oh, here we are, back to action. Singapore coming out with their two stars, JJ and Payne. They've been known to light it up. And it looks like 24, 20, and 21, their big dogs are back on the court as well. I'm looking to see some penetration by 24.
The big dog. Can you name what former player was nicknamed the big dog?
Purdue, Glenn Robinson.
There we go.
24 brings it up. Looks to swing it. Flex cut, come for 21, the low post. He's facing up, he's shooting that. Hadn't hit one since. Oh, and the push in the back.
That was an excellent good call. I could see that from
yep.
here.
Yep.
Good catch by the referee there.
Good box out by Jalen. Looks like they're in the 1-1. This is exactly what Singapore needs. Score with the clock stop, Buford.
Yeah, you were making that point back before, if ideal situation being scoring without the clock moving, and that's what they get a chance to do here.
Let's see what it'll do. The southpaw connects. Nothing but cotton, Buford. Nothing but cotton.
Nothing but cotton.
I have a feeling that's nylon, though. Offensive rebound. Let's see what they'll get. No need to rush it. No need to rush it. Down by three. Dribble handoff. He goes baseline. He has the size advantage. Can't connect. But the freshman with the rebound. Tied up. What's the call here? What's the call?
I think they caught a foul on SAS there.
Oh, wow. Questionable. Good recognition by JJ to take the smaller freshman to the hole, but he just can't connect. I think he needs to go straight up versus trying to get into the defender's body, drawing the foul. He just needs to finish, Buford.
It's a good point with a smaller man on him. Uh-oh.
Yes. 8 seconds.
Yeah, good. I was watching that 24-second clock. He was caught right before he got it over, so... Good call there by the refs, and Singapore ball down three, 2 minutes and 16 seconds left.
I think Singapore really needs to keep the pressure on the defense. Jakarta is in foul trouble. They have five fouls on the team. Dribble handoff, going to the cross screen, look for the pick and pop. JJ takes it upon himself to get to the hole. Can't finish again. Jalen keeps it alive though, out to 10.
For three, that would tie it.
Oh! Singapore is going crazy in the house, all tied up. His third three of the night in the second half. Oh, that's a foul on 24. Yes. Yes, that's a foul on 24. I saw it. I saw it with my own two eyes.
I saw it too. It was right in front of us. But good job, Cotton. All right. Well, this is a big moment here. Singapore step into the line with a chance to take the lead. A minute 49 left. JJ at the line. Who else would they possibly want?
Hey, outside pain.
Oh, we stand corrected. He's not going to the line.
Is that an offensive foul?
Not quite sure.
Must have been because it was an offensive foul.
Ah. Cotton
cross
saves
screen.
The day again with his explanations.
Gonna pop. 10's going to pop. JJ goes middle again. Driving kick to Wyatt. Nothing. Payne has it for three. Puts it up. Air ball. Saved by Jalen Drew up. Oh, that's going to be a jump ball.
It's uncanny. It is absolutely uncanny, Cotton. Jakarta's I was talking ball. To you about this earlier today before we were on the air, but the amount of balls this tournament that have gotten stuck like right on the rim like that, it's just...
I've seen
such a rarity.
Myself. One, which they took 5 minutes just to get down, Buford.
Well, that was about 5 seconds. Ball's back in play.
Well done by the crew here at ISM.
16.
Oh! The second time.
Once again, just as hurt by that 8-second rule, getting it up to half court.
Incredible pressure by Singapore.
Minute 18 left, 54 all.
What are they going to do? What are they going to do? Here we go, cross screen, pick and pop. JJ goes baseline, and he traveled.
That was a good call there.
Good defense, too, by Passion.
Yep. Intensity is this high right now.
Speaking of Passion, I think Passion needs to bring the passion.
All right.
I don't think he scored all half. Jakarta breaks the press.
You love that diaper, Danny, and right there he delivered a beautiful assist there.
Half court pass. The cross. JJ gets it at the top of the key. Good defense by Jakarta. Well, well done. That's off Jakarta.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. Well, I'm not sure our audience at home can actually see the shot clock. It's 10 seconds.
Box three. Expect JJ to get the ball back. Good defense. Great block. We got a barn burner here, Buford.
We do indeed. Couldn't ask for anything better than this. 2-point just lead. 49.1 seconds left.
Here comes the freshman. Here comes the freshman. Swings it back to Passion. Passion bringing it up, loses it. Oh, that's a bit out of control. I think JJ slipped. And then the collision.
Not sure
ensued.
He slipped. He was going after that ball, but. What's going on here? We got free throws. Both teams are in the bonus here.
Passion cannot connect. That would have potentially gave him an opportunity to make it a 4-point game. Let's see if he'll get the next one.
It's still going to be a one possession game no matter what
and
happens.
And he made
here.
It. And he made it.
All right, let's see what Singapore does here. They've been attacking. Let's see what goes on here.
JJ comes off the double and he's. Whoa! NBA three-pointer. Big, big shot. What you saw right there, Buford. He had the double high ball screen. Payne on the strong side. JJ comes off Payne's high screen and then Payne faded off the opposite.
How many threes is that for 10 here? Is that his third three of the half?
Like that's his fourth.
Is it four? He's been absolutely critical in this run that's happening here. We really couldn't ask for anything more. So 30 seconds left, all knotted at 57.
I think I've seen that set run by the Golden State Warriors for Klay Thompson and Steph Curry. You know what? A good shooter can set a great screen and get open.
There we go.
Pick and pop.
Number 10 is shooting like Steph Curry right now. So let's see what just dials up here out of this timeout. They're going to get the ball at over half court here.
You got 30 seconds left in the game. You got 24 seconds to shoot it. I think they'd be patient. They take the best shot they can get. They've defended pretty well all game. They missed. They have a good defense to fall back on, although Singapore, they found momentum. They're hitting down shots, knocking down shots. So we'll see. We'll see. Time will tell, Buford. Time will tell.
About 30 seconds will tell.
Passion has it off the high ball screen. Fakes. Kicks it. Diaper Dandy. Diaper Dandy with an extra pass for three. No. Singapore chases down the rebound. Oh, that's a charge. No. What's the call? They called a block. Maybe he was moving.
They called a block there? My first reaction was the same as yours, Cotton. I thought that was a charge. But That was not the call.
But we're not referees.
We are
not commentators.
We are not. We should stick to what we know best.
And he connects. Connects on the first one. 1 point lead with 15 seconds left. Let's see if Jakarta will call a timeout if he makes this. Remember, they can advance the ball with a timeout. Missed it. Singapore with a big offensive rebound. What happened? They called the foul on Singapore. They're going to the line, huh?
Is that an offensive foul? So they're not going to go to the line. Isn't that right, Cotton? They're going full court pressure here.
Singapore cannot foul. The Jakarta coach is upset about something. Ball's in to Passion, 24. Kicks it up to 13. 13 goes
about
middle,
five.
Kicks it back to Passion. Passion for the win. No!
Oh!
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 Whoa! Offensive rebound by Jakarta. Nobody saw that coming. Buford, this could potentially be just his first IASIS championship since 1990. Guess.
You know what that play reminded me
of,
Cotton?
1992.
I would like to take all our viewers out back in time to 1983. A little bit of a different scenario. But we had Jim Valvano's NC State Wolfpack against the Houston Cougars. Derek Wittenberg's near half-court shot, caught by Lorenzo Charles, and dunked with no time left. Well, looks like we have what, point one?
This can only be tipped in. The only way they can score is if they tip it in. They have to throw it to the rim. Number 21 in the right place at the right time.
Now,
didn't give up on the shot. Saw it coming.
I'm going to predict a screen towards the rim. They've got Jis has number 16 back there.
I would put everyone there
to try and protect.
Catch and shoot it. It's got to be a tip. And it's up. Oh, no. Jis with the win. First time since 1992. Congratulations to them. And we said it early in the first half, offensive rebounds.
Wow.
That was the difference.
Well, really a great, great, great game. Great effort by both squads. Emotions are everywhere on this floor, and you would expect nothing else.
Heart goes out to Singapore.
Great effort by SAS.
Heart goes out to Singapore.
And just
both. They fought back. Great defense in that last possession. Just couldn't rebound. But who would have thought it was going to be nothing but air? Tough for the defense.
Wow. Spectacular game.
Well, there you
go,
Jakarta, 2017.
Congratulations to both teams. What a fantastic final.
I'm out.
Right to the last point one
on
the second. Let's give Singapore a big round of applause. Well done, Eagles. And a big round of applause. Congratulations, 2017 IASIS Boys Basketball Champions. Jakarta Intercultural School.
That was so much fun. I can't wait to listen to this.
What a wonderful match. We'd like to call on, we'll get the ladders out at either end. We'd like to call up ATAC boys, can you please bring out the ladder and the scissors? ATAC boys, can you please bring out the ladder and the scissors? We will ask the Jakarta boys to cut down the net at the entry door end, and the Taipei girls, please come out to the scoreboard end. Okay, let's give a round of applause again for the Taipei American School Tigers, the girls' champions this year. They're going to come forward and cut down the net. And then we'll transfer up to the other end, and the Jakarta boys can do the same at their end. Parents, you may come out, take some photographs out on the floor.
Team captain Lauren Van Doren. Team captain Tiffany Chen. Senior Katie Chang. Senior Josie Hu. Sophomore Cheyenne Shea. Junior Catherine Ye. Sophomore Georgia Van Doren. Sophomore Stephanie Wang. Sophomore Anya Lai. Sophomore Jasmine Ding.
Coach Kim Kawamoto.